Hello guys, this is going to be a review on Xsplit Gamecaster. At the moment I've had a little bit of play with it, and so far I really enjoy this program. It's super easy to use. It's just got a flavour to it that what I'm using at the moment, which is Fraps, It just makes life a lot easier, because at the moment what I'm doing to record for my Let's Plays is I am using Fraps, I'm using Audacity, and I'm using Open Broadcaster to record my face cam. So what this basically does, it puts all of these three into one. Well, you can edit the audio, but the audio is nice, crisp and clear. I will show you a game I play on it in a little while. However, I just want to go through the Gamecaster settings so far, so you can have a taste for what you can do with it. I won't be able to show you all of the settings because I don't have the setup for that. But yeah, with this, you can set this up for your Twitch, which I've done, and my YouTube. You can also set up for Facebook, Twitter, and Google Plus. I haven't set up Google Plus yet, because I don't tend to use Google Plus or Facebook as much as Twitter, but I've put my Twitter onto there, so you can have a look. If we move on to settings, my camera's not available because for some reason it is, there we go. There we go. Oh, camera's still not available. Okay, that's fine. What this is basically saying is, this is my stream setting options, which is 1080p, full HD, I think, actually, I'm going to change the recording settings to 1080p, and I'm going to drop that down to 720 because of my setup. Okay. So, I can do 720p, well, I've done it with Open Broadcaster, so it should be fine. You can also set it, so it is automatic. It automatically sets up for what your internet can do. But I'm going to have a try with this on a live stream that I'm going to be doing next week. So, I'm going to be using this as a true test for what I can do with it. But up to now, it's been very intuitive. You can, if I just show you this, you can enable a Be Right Back graphic. I think you can update this. Yeah, it updates the things on the bottom here with your account. So if I were to add my Facebook, it would appear here or somewhere along that bottom line. You can, as you can see here, change what it is. So I can add an image from my computer. I can pretty much do anything I want with this. So if I close this down and go back. So that's nice and easy. With this as well, you can do your games frame per second, which is really, really handy. Just say, okay, I'm recording at this frames. I'm doing okay for frames. So you can lower the settings if you so want. CPU load as well. That is, it's very, very useful, I think. So you can see, okay, my CPU is getting a little bit loaded here. I can bring the settings down or do whatever. You can also change the location of it. So you can do it to the center. Top center, top left, top right, bottom right, bottom center, bottom left. I tend to put it on top left because it's just habit from what I've been using with Fraps. You can also set hotkeys. So it's, I'm very used to my record button being the F9. All you need to do is just click onto here, F9, pow. And from then on, if I pushed F9, I would record start and stop. So I'm just going to switch this off for now, because the way that Xsplit does it, I think is very, very cool, because with this, you can control tab and it will bring up a screen at the top where we'll have like this. That's exactly what it will bring up. You can stream. I haven't tried that. As I said, I'm going to be trying it next week, on Saturday. Recording as well. That's for in the game. So it's for local record. You can also mute or unmute your microphone, speakers, webcam, Twitch as well. That's really handy, because what I'm using with Open Broadcaster, I have to have, well, I've got two screens. I've got this screen here, and I've got a screen over to that side of where the screen is. So I'd have my game playing here with Open Broadcaster, and then I'd have to have all the Twitch chat and everything on my other window. So that just made everything a little bit easier, or not easier. It made it harder. So what this is going to do is it's going to consolidate everything. Everything's in one place, so you don't have to go fishing around or taking your eyes off the game, because that's one of the things I've found very much with Open Broadcaster is you're having your game here and you having to look elsewhere. Yeah, I could put it into the stream here or probably around here, but if it's a big game, every space you need to fill up. So yeah. What else is there with this? Recordings as well. You can, this is blank, but what you can do as well is when you record all of your videos and everything, they will all appear here, and all you can do is just double click and it will bring up a video of it, and so you can see what your quality is. Also at the bottom, if you've got your account with me, it's prototype 12112, you can outpost them to Facebook, to Twitter, or anything that you have signed up. Yeah, so that's pretty much everything that I can show you from this. Oh, if you do have any other queries about tutorials or another frequently asked question, there's pretty much, I've had a look at the 2 minutes starter, because when I had a little bit of trouble with it when I first got the program, it wouldn't load up faster than light. What I was testing it with wouldn't load up first off, so I had to close this and re-upload it. And when I went back onto Steam and loaded it up, it worked absolutely fine from there. There's no lag in the game. I don't think it uses that much CPU, so like Fraps does, but, and the file sizes are so much smaller than Fraps. So you can have a full Let's Play for about 15, 20 minutes, possibly even 30 minutes, and it'll be a fraction of the size of what Fraps is. So that is a very, very good point for this game. This software. Also, what I've also got down here, if I just bring it across, I have the Broadcaster as well. Now, as you can see, I've had a look down here. If I just go onto the webcam, you can see me there. You can do, you can resize it, you can, yeah, so you can do all that. You can just pop it anywhere. But also the thing that I really, really like is the scene changes. Because as you can see down here, it's completely different. So if you're streaming and you want to, if you want to go away and do something, anything, you can just go pow, go to this one, and there's going to be no change whatsoever. So, pow. We'll go back to that one. You can also do a screen region as well. So if you're doing a broadcast on a how to do something, you can use this program and capture only what you want to show, which I haven't used another program that has that. So I was really, I've tried it out and it is so good. If I just go onto the add, you can add camera, add more media files, screen region, that's what I'm saying. Add an IP camera. Right, I haven't tried that one, but what that basically means is you can have multiple cameras or face cams up at the same time, what I can gather. You can add a game, so you've got a specific game that you can do. You can also edit that as well, which I've done. You can add a Skype video as well, and more sources. But this is for image, slideshow, live stream, starboard, title, video, and whiteboard overlay. So that's quite cool. Hang on, what's that? Whiteboard overlay. Allows you to draw sketches. Ah, okay, that's fine. One of the things I would like to see is to do your own overlay for this, because I've got something that I use in my streams that goes around the outside, a border for my thing. I'm not sure you can do it on this one, but yeah, if I just go onto here as well, you can add, you can change your coding in here for your recordings. You could do standard, high, very high, ultra high, and custom. Not sure what those do, to be honest. I haven't played that much with this. If I just set it to high, don't know exactly what that did. Yeah, okay. So I'll just leave that as it is for the moment. Another one, general settings. This is one of the things that I quite like. You can do your microphone as well, set where you're going to be recording from your audio. You can record your location, where the stream will go as soon as you've done it or finished it. You can do resolutions for your game, and these came already automatically done. So I think these are the favorite ones that people do. It also goes up to really ridiculously high settings, so it just caters for everybody. That is the reviews I've got for this game. I got it through Freedom, their thing. Bottom line for this, I really recommend getting this software, because it is a software where everything is included, everything is in one place, as I said at the beginning of this. It is well worth it, and it's $5 per month. I'm not sure what that is in pounds. It's probably about £2 to £4, something in that region. It's not very much, but yeah, it mounts up, but it's well worth it. If I don't get what they recommend through the seat for my revenue to £5 every month, I'm still gonna pay it. I'm still gonna pay out and get Xsplit for my videos, because as I said, it's such a wonderful, wonderful program. I would show you it running, but I can't record all of what it's showing, all it's showing me, and also the game at the same time. I don't have that luxury or setup, or I don't know what to do with it. Okay, guys, that is all of it. And I will, I'll see you in my main videos. And, yeah. All right, take care, guys. Okay, and here we are. We are streaming. We're recording. Here is... Let me just sort that out. There we go. One of the things I will say with this is there may be a slight delay with my face cam and my audio. Not sure if that's part of the game, but that is something to heed when having this game. Or having this software, I should say. Yeah, it's, as you can see on the top left, I've got, well, no, you can't see it, but I've got three things saying record, saying 1080p, as we were saying, frames per second, and CPU. So, I'm going to go on to continue a game. I've done a little bit, I'm only going to be going around showing this, but yeah, as you can see with this, I can move the camera to wherever I want to go onto the screen, because with this game you may need to move the camera because you will have to change for moving from place to place. So if I just get an enemy just to show you what I mean. Instead of that offer, we're just gonna have a quick little game just to show you guys this game and also what Xsplit can do. Because I'm not recording anything, I'm not using Audacity, I'm not using anything else. I'm going to accept the offer for now because I'm not going to be playing for a lot longer. Also as well, there's the Twitch thing as well, I was saying. Okay, I don't think you can see this on the stream for me recording. Oh yeah, I can. Yes. Oh, okay, they can't do it at the moment. But I've just put in the ticket saying I would like it to be a thing. At the moment I can't see it, but you can't see it either. Okay, another thing with this, what I can see, is there is a function, so if I had a green screen here, I could eliminate everything but me. So that's quite cool. But yeah, that is all I just wanted to show this quickly to you, just saying the level of this. I think I'm going to be reducing it from 1080p to 720 because my system can't deal with it, it seems, but I'll have to see what it's like in editing. Okay, guys, I'll see you in my main videos. Take care.